Czech owned European firm that specialized entirely on the production of fabric ducting and diffusers. It is one of the leading manufacturers in premium fabric ducting and diffusers in commercial, healthcare and industrial application with various tailor-made solutions. MS Piroda has 43 contractual sales offices globally working on an exclusive distributorship basis and operate in 66 plus countries across the world. Mr. Ullas Vatpal is the Managing Director of MS Piroda India Private Limited. His main focus is on business across India and nearby countries like Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, Nepal and Middle East market. Academically, Mr. Ullas Vatpal is a mechanical engineer with MBA in sales and marketing and has 14 plus years of strategic experience in HVACR segment in India and Middle East. He has responsibilities of company establishment, brand management, strategic sales, business development of various Indian and European brands. And since 2005, he has explored various challenging responsibilities in project sales and channel sales with prestigious organizations like ETA, Blue Star, Voltas and Danfoss. It is the assigned as well as untapped and in assigned as well as untapped regions. So with that, I would like to formally welcome Mr. Ullas Vatpal to the presentation and hand over the presentation to him so that he can start the technical talk with the students. And again, sir, welcome very much. Thank you very much for giving your time and welcome to the technical talk.
Perfect. Thank you, Mr. Mazumdar. And I hope I'm audible to everyone.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You're
audible. Okay, yes, great. Yes. So welcome to everyone and thanks to ISRAE Kolkata chapter and for giving us an opportunity to reconnect with the students. And we are just feeling like we are the part of the college from a few years back. And it is a great opportunity for us to demonstrate and discuss about the HVAC and our industry along with the ISRAE platform. Today, along with me, my colleague, Mr. Pritam Lime and Mr. Rahul Pachil, they are also a part of a panelist, and we have divided the total session into the three parts. The first part, which I would like to give the brief to the students about exactly how the HVAC industry is working and what is the role of a duct, where exactly it is coming, and what are the opportunities for the duct designing or the air distribution industry into the India. So with your permission, I wanted to share my screen. So if you can just allow me or give me the...
Yeah, definitely, Mr. Ullas. This is Somajit Banerjee. I'll just make you the host.
Yeah, please. Thank you.
Here you go.
Yes, thanks a lot. Perfect. So basically, I hope my screen is now visible.
Yes.
Perfect. So today's topic, what we are going to discuss and wanted to elaborate more about the duct designing and opportunities in HVAC and R segments. I believe all are from the mechanical background. So definitely by the end of the third and fourth year, everybody has to go through the RAC subject where the HVAC is one of the part. And this is the things which we are going to learn. And so if you see the screen, the first slide itself, HVAC, our industry is completely combination of every individuals. Like it starts with the client, consultant, architect, contractors, vendors, suppliers, everyone together. So that symbols is resembles about the, it's a teamwork completely. So in HVAC industry, if any clients want to put any kind of the malls, hospitals, or any commercial or industrial segment where air conditioning is one of the important part now. It's not a luxury now, it's a need. So he has to go through all these step-by-step professionals. The first is the architect, MEP consultant, and the civil contractors. The architect who designed the complete system for the client, he's basically the main person who is making the dreams come true in terms of the drawing and the actual visualization of the plant or actual visualization of the building in the first step. The AVP consultant who is doing completely a designing.
Mr. Ullas, I'm sorry to interrupt you. Can you just make me the host one second because we got some small technical glitch. Just one second if you can make me the technical host.
Yeah. Miss, you want me to make you?
Beside my name, there's a three dots. You just they click the dot and there will be a option called make host.
Make host, huh?
Yeah. I'm sorry you have to interrupt you like this.
No issue. Meeting info, make host, three dots. Not actually. Just hold on. Stop share. More.
There is a mute button, and beside that there will be a
yes. So, Mr. Somajit, did it.
Right.
I hope for you.
Just a second.
Somajit, sir, if you just see on the share button on the top right corner of the share button, you can make Ullas sir the presenter. The option is there.
Which side? I'm sorry, I was.
There is a share screen button. Okay.
Yeah, right.
On the top right corner of the share screen button, there is an arrow tab.
Yeah.
You click on that.
Yeah, but it opens my shares screens.
No. There is a top right corner button of where you can, when you click on it, you will say who can share the screen at what time. A dialog box will come up.
Who can share? Yeah, only host and all panelists.
All panelists. Exactly.
Who can share when someone else is sharing? Or the host, all panelists. Okay. Just a minute, Mr. Ullas. Sorry for interruption.
No issue.
So I'll just put one question: who can share with all panelists, and who can share, start sharing? That will keep as host, right?
Exactly, sir.
So Mr. Ullas, can you share your presentation now? You can just open up.
Hello.
Yeah, can you share your presentation?
Yeah, actually, I not hear you what you said.
Can you share your presentation?
Okay. But you asked me something because in between I lost
my. No. That's it. This is the only question which I had.
Okay, perfect. Now it's visible.
Perfect. Perfectly fine, sir. Please go ahead. Sorry.
No issue. Am I audible?
Yes, you are.
Yeah, perfect. So basically, we are just going through the one small tour about the how the HVAC and our systems is completely comprises of what are the systems and then the applications. So when any clients or end user wanted to have some new buildings for the construction, the first step is the architect, MEP consultant, and the main civil contractors. The main civil contractor is the company which is completely building up the structure. MEP consultant, the consultant who is doing the mechanical, electrical, and plumbing designing of the system to suit the client requirement of application and the process. And the architect who is giving the complete, soul to that building in terms of initially visualization. And based on that, there is one PMC, the project management consultants, the companies, they are involved into monitor how the project works take place and how effectively they are monitoring and the executing the works as per the design. So there is a HVAC contractors. So HVAC contractors who is doing the complete, we can say the MEP contractors and the HVAC contractor who is executing the mechanical equipments and the accessories that includes the high side system, low side system, the chiller, A2, fan colony, ducting, pumps, walls, everything. Electrical, plumbing, all together. So they are the HVAC contractors. And then comes to the main equipment manufacturers, like main equipment manufacturer, like the equipment manufacturers for the chiller manufacturer, like the Carrier, Trane, York, Daikin, Hitachi, Blue Star, Holtas, Kirloskar. So, and these are the like Grundfos, Armstrong, Palm, AHU manufacturer, Zico, Estech, VTS. So these are all the companies' name. I'm just giving you a little brief because these are the names you may be familiar, you may not be familiar. But some, if you just Google it, all these names, those who are interested in the HVAC and wanted to join ISHRAE student chapters, it is always important that you are associated with ISHRAE in a very good platform where all these big companies from India and abroad are very much present in India and they have very strong hold into the HVAC and market. Then the next next component is the component manufacturers, like the components which are going to use into the main equipments and during the projects. Then suppliers and dealers and the service dealers. So if you see all these areas which are now in front of you, everywhere as a HVAC or a ISRE certified student, you are having the opportunity to get and work in your future. So it is depends on if those who are interested in the HVAC and our industry should have a utilize the best platform started with their college to understand exactly about the HVAC and to get interacted with the industry professionals on the ISRE platform. So today it's, we are going to discuss on the like topic like what we discussed so far, how HVAC and our industry doing to operate, which are the companies being actively present in India. As I mentioned, these are the companies are already actively present in India. You can anytime find out from the Google or you can check with the ISRE student chapter. And opportunity within and outside India. It's of course HVAC is not a luxury now, it's a need. And which are the ways to approach? Of course, the first platform is the ISRE student chapter. The second it's your ISRE junction, job junction, your LinkedIn profile. You have to stay connected with the industry professional in HVAC. Of course, this is a systematic approach for the growth. You have to understand exactly what are the new technologies are coming into the market and how they are going to develop. And of course, today's topic is basis of duct design. So what is exactly the duct? How it will be a part of HVAC system? So basically duct is a simple way, if I'm to define it, it's a conduit or it's a passage from where air is traveling from one point to another point. Like if you are sitting in a cinema theater, we are getting the cold air from various corners. It's like a uniform distribution. So air is coming from where? It's coming from the grills because that is visible. But will it be coming from grills or is there anything another component is behind that? Yes, behind that it is a duct. So is it coming from the duct? Yes, because it is coming from the duct. But how that air is coming there in a duct? So duct is connected to the ductable units or air handling units. Oh, so air handling unit is creating the air. Yes, air handling units and the ductables are creating there. But exactly how that air is getting created? So air is getting created with the proper fans and air distribution systems and the ventilation systems. So if you see all this is interconnected, how we will get the cold air? Because cold air we are getting because there is a cooling coils in the HU. So how that will work? So that is a part of the air handling units. So similarly, how that chilled water is getting into the HU. It is getting into the HU through the chillers from the chilled water piping. So all these are interrelated with the HVAC components and the products. So today's topic, we are going to focus mainly on the ducting system, that is the air distribution systems. In India, there are the various conventional way of doing ducting, that is the galvanized iron, stainless steel, metal, aluminium. These are the regular, you can say the material of construction for the ducting. And this ducting is right now using from so many years, we are using this ducting with the proper guidelines as per this MACNA and the HVAC industry. And today my colleague Pritam and the Rahul, they are going to take a tour about the what are the different types of ductings are available and what are the new ways of ductings are already emerging into the India market. So I wish everyone's good luck. And I request everyone to have your keen attention and the active participation during the presentation so that we can elaborate more and more. So end of the session, if people can ask more questions, we'll be more happy to explain. So I'm giving it to my colleague Pritam to take up the discussions to the further level.
Thank you, Ulla sir, for passing me this presentation. And first of all, I just want to thank ISRE Kolkata chapter for giving us opportunity. So am I audible to you all?
Yes, Mr. Pritam, you are.
Yeah. Yes, so I'm just going to share my screen. I'm just requesting Ulla sir to cancel
your screen. Yeah, I can.
Okay. Thank you. I'm just sharing my screen. Okay, my screen is visible to you all.
Yes, you need just need to put it on presentation mode. Perfect. Now it's done.
Perfect. Yeah.
Thank you. So as it is mentioned by Ulla, so today we are going to discuss about the Duck design basics. So these are the main basic points I just want to conclude in today's session. So first one is like around function of Duck. Second one is materials of Duck. Third one is classification of Duck. Fourth one is methods of Duck design. Fifth one is economic factors influencing Duck layout. And last one is the practical example of Duck design, metal ducting and fabric ducting. So my colleague Rahul is also here. He is going to show how exactly we are designing the duct in HVAC industry. So I think all students will be get how to design the ducting system at the basics, what we need to design the metal duct as well as the other ducting system. So first one is function of duct. As Ulla sir also mentioned regarding ducts are conduits or passages used in heating, ventilation and air conditioning to deliver and remove air. So these ducts are very much depend on the available space, what is the friction loss inside the duct, the velocity and the sound level, as well as heat losses. So the air include, for example, like supply air, return air and exhaust air. So in HVAC industry, the ducts are used to supply air as well as to return the takeout air, as well as to exhaust the air from any application, which is like commercial or industrial. So these are some duct materials. The first one is GI sheets, galvanized iron sheets. This is the most commonly used duct material in all applications, as well as commercial, industrial, pharmaceuticals. So thickness of sheet varies from 0.5 mm to 1.6 mm. So example for these GI sheets ducts like residential, hospitals and offices. Second one is carbon steel. It is resistant to heat used in high temperature applications. The example is like kitchen hood. Okay, so the third one is aluminium ducts. Aluminium ducts are used in hygienic applications like in OT rooms, X-ray rooms, MRI rooms. The next one is copper ducts. Copper ducts are used in high humidity area because in high humidity area, there should be a problem of condensation. So copper ducts are using in those conditions. Last one is fabric or textile duct. Fabric or textile ducting are used in uniform distribution, are used for uniform distribution for the aesthetic appearance, as well as these ducts are very easy to clean. The examples are like public buildings, manufacturing facilities, and exhibition center. Even in some cases, fabric ducts are used in pharmaceutical industries also. So these are some duct classification. First one is according to shape. Next one is according to air type. Third one is according to velocity, and next one is according to drawing shape. So I will just brief you regarding the duct classification one by one. So first one is according to shape. So in shape, there are two shapes, like more than two shapes, like square, rectangular, round and oval. So these are some snaps you can see. So first three snaps are showing the square and rectangular ducting, which is used for supply as well as return air. And second, last three snaps are showing round as well as oval ducting. The fourth snap or left bottom snap is showing round ducting. Here you can see the round duct as well as the diffusion system which is coming out of the duct. These two last two images are for oval ducting. You can see how the air diffusion is designed and how the mounting is installed. We have one video regarding the installation of these ducts and how the metal duct is going to make on site as well as in their manufacturing facility. So I will show the video later. The next type, according to air type. So as already we discussed, the air supply air we are using duct, return air we are using duct, the fresh air also, because of this pandemic situation, most of the consultants are advising to add some fresh air in their air conditioning units. So like AHU manufacturers and other manufacturers are also designing their AHUs with the fresh air. Last one is exhaust air duct. So next type is according to the velocity. So according to velocity, there are three subtypes you can say. The first one is low velocity duct, where the velocity is around 900 to 200 FPM. In meter per second or in SI unit, you can say 4.5 to 10 meter per second. The next one is medium velocity duct. the medium velocity duct is from 2000 to 2500 fpm. In SI unit, we can say like 10 to 13 minutes meter per second. And this last one is high velocity duct, 2500 fpm to 4000 fpm. The in SI units, 30 to 20 meter per second. I just give a little brief about where exactly those velocity means, how we are using these velocities in our application. So like you can see in some offices, we don't require high velocity duct. So we are going with a low velocity duct, because in offices kind of application or in public building application, people don't want to draft the air on their head. So the velocity inside the duct should be low. And in industrial applications where the spot cooling is required, so in those cases, generally consultant are designing the duct with this medium velocity duct. High velocity ducts are used for like if there is any highly spot cooling application where draft of the air are required. So in those cases, only the high velocity ducts are used. So last type is according to the drawing. First subtype, we can say the single line ducts. We are calling in our language like SLD. And another one is a double line duct. So here in single line duct or in SLD ducts, you can see the line, there is a one planum, or we can say the AHU of 25,600 CFM, and some lines are going out of this. So from this planum, like you can say on the right side, one line is going. On top of this planum, one line is going. On left side, one line is going. And we have divided these lines with CFM calculation. So this is a basic routing, basic route of the ducting system, which we are going to design. So my colleague Rahul is going to explain how we are going to design these ducts, and from the single line diagram, how we are changing to the actual double line diagram. So in second image, you can see the double line ducts. Here you can see the actual measurement of ducting system in double lines. From left side, you can see some CFM is coming and the double line ducting, actual duct dimension is going to the straight, and some branches are going out from this main duct. So the next part is the method of duct design. The first one is velocity reduction method. Second one is equal friction method. And third one is static regain method. So first one is, we'll discuss about the velocity reduction method. In this method, the duct design in such a way that the velocity decreases as flow proceeds. So you got my point, means like if the velocity, how is going to run throughout the duct, then we are going to design overall ducting system according to the velocity. So each and calculation of ducting system is depend on the velocity which is coming at the inlet point of the duct. So in this method, we can calculate the pressure drop for each main duct as well as branches also. So also the velocity and the known quantity of air is supplied to the prospective ducts. So as I mentioned, we are going to calculate velocity as well as pressure drop at each point of the duct, whether it is main duct or whether it is the branch of the duct. The second method, which is equal friction loss method, this is very common method all HVAC industry is using this method nowadays, because it is very easy method and we can get very easy designs from this. So we are going to see the practical example about the equal friction method in next part. So in this method, you can see frictional pressure drop per unit length of the duct is maintained constant throughout the duct system. So we are just calculating the frictional pressure drop first, and we are trying to maintain same drop in throughout the system. So the procedure is to be select a suitable velocity in a main duct from the sound level consideration, and knowing the air flow rate from the velocity and the main duct, the size and the friction losses are determined from the friction chart. So we are using the friction chart to calculate the airflow as well as to calculate the velocity. So according to these input parameters, we are going to design this equal friction method. So last one is static regain method. Static regain method, you can see we are going to balance all over the pressure in throughout the system. Means if we are designing ducting system with the main duct, and if we are just considering around the 7 to 8 branches over there, So we are just trying to maintain same pressure in branches also and in main duct also. So this is static regain method. Static regain method is just used when there is a long run of ducting. If we can say like 50 meter or 60 meter of ducting is there. So it is straight ducting. So we can use this static regain method. And it is very, in this case, it is very, what we can say, it is very important to design the main duct because branches which we are going to design. So this main criteria is like, we have to maintain the static pressure throughout the duct system. So it is very, very important to design first main duct. So because if there is a losses, means if there is our branches, then we can see the pressure is going to divide in all branches. So there are some calculations also, means for the static regain method. It's quite a little bit, what we can say, tough calculations, but some of the manufacturers, some of the fabric duct manufacturers are using those methods because in this case, the best example for static regain method is the fabric ducts. So next part is economical factors which are influencing the duct layout. So definitely means if any client or any consultant are looking for the most appropriate duct design, so they will also looking for the economical factors. So these are the some economical factors: heat gain or loss from the duct, aspect ratio of the duct, duct friction, duct fitting, and duct accessories. So we will discuss about these all economical factors one by one. So first one is like heat gain or loss of the duct. The heat gain or loss in the supply and return duct system is considerable. As you all know, means air is going to flow throughout the duct system. There will be some losses. If you are going through the equal frictional, then there will be some pressure losses. If you are going to design through static regain, then there are no any pressure losses, but there are losses because of the material. There are losses because of surrounding duct. If there is heat generation or heat is more outside the duct, then there are losses inside the duct. So this kind of losses we are getting when we are designing, we have to consider while we are designing the duct. So the next point I am mentioning, like if we are just rotating one duct through unconditioned space, then there will be some losses or heat gain in the duct. And the allowance must be made for a heat loss or gain in the load. Means we have to consider these losses or heat gain while we are calculating the ducting system, while we are calculating the CFM or airflow of this specific area. So in those cases, we have to reconsider. I mean, we have to consider those points. The next one is aspect ratio. Aspect ratio is a very important point or very important commercial factor in the case of designing the ducting. So aspect ratio is defined as like longer side of the rectangular duct to the shorter side of the rectangular duct. So it is very clear, means here you can see from the diagram, the A by B is the aspect ratio mathematically. So you can see, means if you are just considering any rectangular or square duct, so there should be some aspect ratio, because for the round duct, there should be no any aspect ratio. And if you are considering any square duct by any size, the aspect ratio should be 1. Aspect ratio increases more metal surfaces required to fabricate duct. As aspect ratio, the value of the aspect ratio is increased, then we are require more material to fabricate the duct. I have one example with my notes in the next slide. I'm just explaining this. Okay, so here you can see on the right side, case one and case two. These are two cases over there. So first case is for rectangular duct. Second one is for the square duct. So I'm just calculating the area for these two ducts. So first duct is around 8 feet by 2 feet, and second one is 4 by 4. So this is a square duct. So aspect ratio will be the 1 definitely. We'll discuss about the rectangular duct. So in rectangular duct, you can see the area is coming around 16 feet square. Perimeter I'm calculating. The perimeter is coming around 20 feet. So in square duct also, the area is coming same, but perimeter is coming less because the aspect ratio of the square duct is very less. So this shows that the material required to fabricate the ducting, to manufacture the ducting, when the aspect ratio is less, in that case material required is very less. So aspect ratio value for the rectangular duct is maximum is 4. We have to, while designing, we have to consider aspect ratio less than 4 only or equal to 4. So the third point is duct friction. Duct friction, as we discussed, like means when there is a air is coming from the AHU or from the any air conditioning unit, there are some contact with the duct, with the metal duct. So there are some friction losses. Due to these friction losses, we required the high energy fan in AHUs or fan coil units, or we can say the ductable units. So this is resulting into the increase in the value of project, and it will create more noise in the duct. So it is very, very, we have to careful in those conditions while designing the duct. So aspect ratio and duct friction are quite similar terms. So we have to design the duct with less than 4 aspect ratio, which resulting into the, it will, we can decrease the value of the project, because in that case, if aspect ratio is less, friction losses are less. And in that case, the AHU fan, which is going to install in AHU, so we don't require any, what we can say, the high high kilowatt fan or high kilowatt motor. So we can reduce the overall consumption and we can decrease the project value. So fourth point is duct fittings. So this point contains some of the duct fittings. As you can see, there are some duct fittings you can see over here, like square means high value of square to low value of square. You can see some arc over there, you can see some bends over there. So these are duct fittings which are used to change the direction. And now we are just moving to the here, sorry, in down also you can see there are some small duct fittings, like some flanges over there. Some gaskets, some carriage bolts over there, flange nuts are there. So these are small duct fittings, but main duct fittings, what we can see the images in front of you. And as I said, these duct fittings are used only to change the direction. Yeah, definitely while calculation, while designing, we must consider those fittings if we want to rotate the duct from one side to another. Next one is duct accessories. There is a main difference in duct fitting and duct accessories is duct fittings are used to change the direction, but duct accessories are used to control the airflow. So while what we can say in interviews, I was faced those questions in my interviews. So these duct accessories are used to control the airflow. So you can see, like there are some volume control dampers, there are some butterfly dampers, and there are fire dampers. So these volume control dampers, there are two types, like manual and automatic. Automatic we can use by adding some motor element for the damper, and we can control the airflow which is going to the duct. And these dampers are used because we have to balance the system, overall duct system. So in those cases, we are using such a volume control dampers. Butterfly dampers are also quite same, but these are in round shape, and you can see there is a one flip inside the damper. So we can control this flip and we can control the airflow by controlling this flip inside the damper. Fire dampers are used when there is a one room and we are passing duct from one room to another. And if we are installing the fire damper at the center, means in between the two rooms, then if there is some fire in one room, it will cannot pass to second room because of this fire damper. So this is very must. We have to use fire dampers when we are crossing the rooms. These are some videos I just want to show you. So this first video is the manufacturing of metal ducting at site, or we can say at their process. I hope you all able to see this video.
Yes.
Okay. So I'm just moving forward. So this person is now going to cut this sheet, metal sheet, GS sheet, we can say, and they have some dimensions with them. So they are manufacturing or they are managing this duct according to the dimension. I'm just moving it because, yeah, so this person now made one arc over here, and according to dimension with him, So you can see, means this one kind of accessories we can say he made over here to change the direction of the air. So we are just moving to the second video. In second video, you can see how it's very tough to install metal ducting on site by using this scaffolding and all things. So it's a little bit tough while installing metal ducting on site, and we have to take care all the safety functions, like we have to wear the shoes, the install people supposed to wear the helmets. So all we have to take care on the site while installing the metal ducting. So this is video for installing metal ducting. You can see I'm just moving to the next video. So in next video we are going to see, as we already discussed about the oval ducting also, means while in first discussion, according to the shape, so we have discussed about the oval ducting. So this is the oval ducting. They are installing oval ducting. It is factory manufactured, so we can see the pre-manufactured from the factory directly coming to the site just for the installation. So these people are just installing the oval ducting on the site. So you can see it's a little bit tough while installing, but it is already manufactured from factory, so they are not taking so much time. They are just connecting modules on the site. They have already installed some mountings over there to hang the duct from the ceiling. So this and the last one I just want to show you, this is the one of the case study of the fabric ducting where manufacturer had done some smoke test on the side. So here you can see the fan and the air is coming from this fabric. So as I mentioned, this is very, very critical, like in some cases the uniform distribution. So in both cases we need to design fabric ducting very well. So here you can see the smoke coming out from these micro perforations. So we are not able to see any air distribution from down, but there is an air distribution inside the duct. So my colleague Rahul is now going to represent the next slides. I'm just closing my screen. He's going to discuss about the practical example of duct design. How is we are designing the duct in our industry. Thank you.
Okay, thanks Pritham. Thank you for your wonderful presentation. I will take the charge from here. So hello everyone, this is Rahul Patil. I am leading the design and application department for Priyuda India. So let's start with the further presentation. Okay. So is my screen visible?
Yes.
Yes, it is visible, Rahul.
Okay. So I hope everybody paid attention to what Pritham said, because everything is interrelated. It is like a jigsaw puzzle. So each thing shall come up in practical design also. I know as you are all engineering students, so you are a bit more interested in design part rather from the technical theory part. So let's go ahead with the fun part now, practical design. So yes, as Pritham said, there are three different sizing methods, just a little brush up of them: equal friction method, velocity reduction method, and static regain method, which is commonly used for fabric ducting. So first, equal friction method, it is more generally used as a common tool of duct sizing and duct designing by all contractors and all consultants for in case of GI ducting, because it is very easy and there is a proper like a easy method available for it, and the calculation is very less time consuming. So the second method, it is also easy, but it is a bit more time consuming, so it is just kept for a bit more precise jobs. And third method, static rigid method, generally if you go with manual sizing by this method, it will take more and more time, like 3 to 4 times more time than equal friction method. So normally proprietary software is used for this for a duct design with a static rigid method, which is always available with fabric ducting manufacturing companies. So yes, let's proceed with the practical example. So let's try to size a duct with an equal friction method, which is commonly used by contractors, which is commonly used for GI ducting sizing. See, we are before starting this, I'm emphasizing on we are introducing you to both methods, which is commonly used and which is rarely used. First is commonly used method is the equal friction method. You have to know the market, you have to know what is going on in the market and what is emerging trend. So we will try to explain you what is currently going on with the duct designing part in the market, and it is equal friction method. So let's consider the application of a cafeteria. So like I have shown over here, this is the application. Consider this is a cafeteria. The unit is kept over here, and we have to distribute air over the tables. One table is here, here, and here, and here. Okay. So this, just note this diagram or keep it in your mind or take a screenshot. We will require it later. So what are the key input parameters for it? So most of all, I think fourth year students might know from their REC subject, important parameters for a room design is CFM, which is obtained from a heat load calculation. Heat load calculation is nothing but the total amount of heat which is generated inside the room, which need to be countered with the cooling air, is to be calculated. So this is a different part, and it is a big process. It can be you can easily learn it from the internet. And second is the velocity. It is also calculated from a recommended velocity table. I will cover it from the next slides. So if you have screenshotted this diagram, there is an AHU. AHU is nothing but the pump in case of air. Okay, so if you might have been familiar with the pump, a general purpose pump, what it does, it moves the water from one stable source towards the area which needs to be delivered. Same in case of air. The air needs to be moved from one area to another with certain pressure. So it is handled by this AHU. So this AHU is the prime driver of air over here. So we need a 4000 CFM of air. So this AHU is designed as per that, and it will deliver a 4000 CFM of air with a certain static pressure. Okay, so let's consider the below parameters. So first one is CFM. It is around 4000 CFM, or if you consider into the other unit, it is 1888 liter per second. A simple conversion is given below. Okay, so velocity we have selected is a 9.8 meter per second from this table. This is a recommended velocity table from the bigger organizations which standardize the unit, like ASHRAE. So for residence, it is 3. Okay, for apartments, it is around 5. For theaters, around 7. And for cafeterias, it is around 9. So we have taken 9. So it is 9 meter per second. When we convert to feet per minute, it will be around 1800. And the recommended ambient temperature as per ASHRAE is 25 degrees Celsius at rate 50 RH. It is a recommended ambient temperature for human comfort application. Normal human beings shall be comfortable at this. So let's see how we can proceed further. So normally what the contractors do for the GI ducting sizing is to use manual calculations, or recently a software induced help has been taken. So this is a simple software known as Duct Sizer. So by using this software, all the input parameters or the FTA Excel sheets is eliminated. So we just have to input parameters which we got from the earlier heat load calculation, the airflow, and the velocity from the recommended velocity table into it, and we will calculate the head loss for the main duct. So let's open this software first. Okay, it's over here. So this is the software. Okay, so first we will select the 50 degrees Celsius at 25 degrees Celsius at 50 RH, which is around 75 degree Fahrenheit. So let's select this one. Okay, so what we have? We have two parameters. Okay, flow rate as well as the velocity. So we'll click on this both and we'll enter it. So we can enter 4000. Okay, so velocity we have 1800. Okay, so like what we have from this, we have two variables and then we can get one constant. Okay, so what constant we can get is a head loss. This is 0.213 water column per 100 feet. So also this noted down this head loss calculated like 0.213 inches of water column per 100 feet, so that we can use it further by making this constant. So as the name suggests, equal friction method. So in this, as the name suggests, it is the head loss or the friction factor which is kept constant in calculation of various other velocities. So the constants are used in the further calculations shall not be the velocity and flow rate. It shall be flow rate and the head loss. Okay. So first step, we have calculated the head loss 0.213. So let's go ahead. Say consider the duct size as 20 something. Say it is 20. So yes, see the other duct size has been equally got. So write down the duct size. But before writing it, just note that this sizing should be in even numbers, because normally the standards are kept in even numbers. So just see. Now, if you go ahead, we noted down the head loss as this value. Further, you can see the duct size, it is coming as 20 into 17. So let's make it, wait, the greater even number, which is 20 into 18. So further, now let's go backwards. So by this diagram, you can see the main header duct is going ahead and there are branches. Each branch is of 1000 CFM. So what is this? Each branch is doing, like it is drawing 1000 CFM from the main header branch. Okay. So like 1000 CFM is like pulled over here. Then the next is 3000 CFM, which is left. Then again 1000 CFM is pulled. Like that, all the air is distributed. So now we have designed this part from this AHU up till here. So now we have to design the next part, which is a branch from here to here. So let's design. Now let's clear the unit. So now we have flow rate and head loss with us. So we have to design branch of 1000 CFM. Now your head loss as 0.213. Okay. So now we have got the velocity as per the equal friction, which we have kept constant. So let's say we designed the duct again 20. So as you see, the duct has been shrunk in the size. So yes, the next sizing has been done. So note it down that for here to here, for this to this part, the duct dimensions will be 20 inches into 6 inches. So moving further, let's design for the part ahead, which is a 500 CFM. So put it 500 over here. So write down deduct. So yeah, deduct size has been again shrunk. So it is 20 inch by 4 inch. Okay, so write down that. So again, coming to the calculation. If you see, now we noted down for the 1000 CFM, the duct sizing shall be 20 inches by 6 inches. But it should always follow the proper aspect ratio as explained by Pritam earlier. The aspect ratio for rectangle is 4. It should not be greater than 4, or else it will not, it will be causing the turbulent flow, or it will be increasing the friction losses more and more. So as the friction loss increases, the more the static pressure is required, more the static pressure is required, it puts more load on the prime mover of air, which is AHU. Hence, the more kilowatt motor is required in the AHU, thus leading in the higher losses of power. Okay, so electricity losses are done in this case if we didn't select the duct as per the proper aspect ratios. So that should be kept in mind. So how is the aspect ratio can be defined, like it is correct or not? So as per the Pritam slide, aspect ratio should be less than 4. It is 4 is the ideal. So it should be less than 4, not greater than 4. So first, let's calculate the aspect ratio for all. First duct was designed as around 20 by 18. So aspect ratio was 20 divided by 18. So 20 divided by 18, it is 1.11, which is less than 4. Now it is okay, it is acceptable. So let's check the another one for 1000 CFM. 20 divided by 6, it is 3.33. It is also less than 4, so it is also satisfactory. Now let's check the latest one which we have got. It is 20 by 4, right? So 20 divided by 4. If you're seeing here, it is 5. So it is not acceptable. So what we can do?
Rahul, are you calculating the duct design in a different sheet? So that is not visible.
Okay, it is not visible. Actually, I am sharing my screen.
The sheet which is screen which is seen is using duct size the duct, and you have got a write up.
Okay. Just hold on. I think I should share the screen. Okay, now I'm sharing the screen. Okay, so let's do 20 divided by 4. So latest calculation was 20 divided by 4. So 20 divided by 4, it is 5, which is not acceptable. So what can be done in this? So in this case, the duct size should be increased towards the other even value from each other side, either 22 or for the length or as for the width. So we will increase the width again to the 20 by 6. So it can be, aspect ratios can be managed. So it is coming again 3.33. So later all the dimensions can be found like this by cross-checking. So I have mentioned all the dimensions. First dimension was 20 by 18, then 20 by 6. Then we again encountered an error over here. So it now we increase the dimension, so it is coming as 20 by 6. So like that, similar way, calculate all the dimensions. And in the end, your duct design has been completed. So it is simple as that. So one question for you all, like what is this diagram called? As per the previous duct exam, like duct types explained by Pritam, what type is this duct layout called? Okay, it is called as the single wire line diagram of ducting layout. Now I will explain how the double line diagram is carried out. So this is all about the duct sizing. Now we have completed the total duct design for this one. this software, I have mentioned the link over here in this for this application. I will be sharing this presentation also. So this, from this link, you all can download this software, or just Google it, Duck Sizer. You can readily download it from there also. So same example of duct design, how we can calculate in fabric ducting. So yes, the selection based in fabric ducting is on the static Regan method, and the calculations are already embedded in the proprietary software itself. So we need not to do all that Excel stuff, all that calculating stuff on the paper page and later like mess up with the calculations. Like one single digit error from here or there can total mess up all your calculations, because everything is interrelated. And everything is like each term is interrelated for the correct results. So it is very tedious job in error finding also, and for calculations also in this case. So yes, the calculations are embedded in the proprietary software, so you need not to worry itself. So each calculation can be carried out as per design and as per already fed into software. So what input parameters are required in case of this static Regan method? So input parameters required is first of all CFM, then static pressure, which is a head loss, then length of the duct, and additional parameter required for specifically for fabric ducting is a throw angle, because we use the fabric duct as the diffuser itself. So it doesn't have any grills or registers to throw the air, or as well as nozzles also. The duct itself acts like a diffuser. So this is the dashboard of proprietary fabric duct selection software, which is a Preoda software to be precise. So duct shape selection can be done over here. So if you see, there are a lot of shapes. And CFM, as I mentioned, it's available over here. Then duct length, it can be mentioned over here. A duct length can be mentioned over here. Duct diameter, which is mentioned over here. And static pressure, which can be selected over here. So I already made the selection on this Preoda software. Just I will go through it. So yes, first this what we have entered is the duct shape. We require a circular duct over here. We can also select a half round. We can also select a quarter round. Depends upon the sizes and the client requirements and the aesthetic purpose. Half round can also do, as well as circular also do on most cases. So yes, so now we have selected the airflow as 4000 CFM, and the diameter of the duct we have selected with respect to the velocity. The maximum velocity we can select is as a 9 meter per second, but for this safer side and for noise reduction, we have selected it around 8 meter per second. So now these parameters are freeze. Later we have selected the length of the main header and the static pressure around 120, which is a standard static pressure, minimum static pressure which we follow for the fabric duct selection. So if you again go over the diagram, which is single line diagram, this one. So we have selected from here to here, we have selected one header duct, and then later we will select the branch ducts, which can be like connected to the one header duct. So by selecting these parameters directly, you can directly you will get one duct design. If you see, it is as simple. Like I required only 7 parameters, and the duct design is complete in front of me with all velocity parameters, pressures, vibration parameters, deflection, airflow. Everything is calculated on my background just when I was entering the data. This is the beauty of the software. So it reduces your time and also readily provides you data as you are selecting the duct. So what is this? These four circles over here. These are the outputs or the outlet adapters, which I have put in these places. Like one is around 750, around 1500, around 2000, around 3000. So like I have calculated this over here on my AutoCAD software. So I have calculated first outlet shall be at this distance, the second outlet shall be at this distance, third outlet shall be at this distance, and fourth outlet at this distance. So what I have to do, just have to enter the distances and the diameter of the outlet which I required. So rest the software shall do all the balancing for that. If you see, everything has been done. So we can move ahead with this second branch. So this was done like hardly in 10 minutes. So second is the branches. If you go ahead with the technical, I've selected all these size and everything of the branches, and I've selected the zip over here so that it can be connected. So best part is the connection. So I will connect and show you. First, I will select our header duct, which is a 400 CFM and 3000 mm height. Then it readily shows the four adapters, which I have like placed on the distances for the branches. So first branch, I will take from here, connect it. Second branch, I will connect it. Third branch, I will connect it like this. And fourth branch, I will connect it like this. So once the connection is built, just click on drawing and you will get the total diagram of the duct design. So yes, the duct design has been completed for this. The fourth part, the throw angle, which I have showed you, is nothing but the perforations or the throw angles which is needed for the air throw. Like if you require a side throw, or if you require a side throw, then just it is just select the angle. You can move it like here, 20, 180 if you require the throw down. As we require the throw downwards, we will select this 180 degree angle, and we will increase the spacing between rows to cover more area like this. And yes, the duct design has been completed. Same can be replicated to four other branches. Simple as that. So later, the type of installation. So these are different types of installations available in the fabric ducting area, which is very limited in the JI ducting area. So the installation shall be of aluminum profile like this. It can be single suspension, it can be double suspension, it can be triple suspension, it can be like this. So we will go ahead with the single suspension type, profile type. So yes, this is the different types of mounting materials. Like there are total this many types of mounting available in each type. If you can see, there's a lot of customization can be done. It is as simple as that. It is only possible with the software. When you do it manually, you cannot even think of that. Like this many options are available for ducts installation itself. So yes, this is the beauty of the software. So now, when this everything has been finished, just export this diagram from the connections, the drawings. We can just export this over the 3D, and we can just superimpose it like a CAD file. Okay, just save, and then we can superimpose it on the line diagram to make it a two wire diagram. Before this, just I want to explain another thing which we can do with the software, which is we can study the flow profile of the air also, which is I think is the part of your fluid dynamics, because as you know, air is nothing basically a fluid itself. So we can go over here. We can go over the flow profile, and if you can see, the air is reaching over here. So air till 4 meters, air is going with 0.5 velocity. So if you increase the maximum velocity as 1, so you can see the different velocity profiles. Like here, towards the periphery of the airflow, the air will be at lower velocity. When you go towards the inside of the airflow, the air velocity increases. So till 5 meters, we are getting more than 1 meter per second of airflow. So this also can be done with the software. So why it is static regain method I explained all this. So how we can, like, what is the proof that we did all this with the static regain method? The proof is nothing but the static pressure from the start to the end. It is constant. If you see on each branches, from it is 100 over here, it is 100 on this over here also. So if you go for position one also, it is 100 over here, it is 100 more than get more or less equal to 100 also. So yes, this is done with the static regain method, because in case of equal friction method, the pressure or pressure will gradually go on decreasing. So the disadvantage of that method is the air velocity, which we get at the starting, we might not get at the ending. So yes, finally, I would like to show you the final diagrams of the fabric duct. So this was a line diagram over here. If you can see over here, this is the line diagram, and this is the branches which were coming over the line diagram. So what I did, I superimposed my fabric duct over here with the branches, and the complete duct design is ready over here. And similar, we can also go ahead with the combination of GI as well as fabric ducts. So to reduce their efforts, the GI ducting guy can only design for main duct. Later, the branches and all the additional things can be designed in the fabric ducting. So there are numerous possibilities. There are numerous things which can be done with the fabric ducting as well as GI ducting, and both can go hand in hand. So yes, that's what I want to conclude with in this part of the duct designing and duct sizing. So thank you. Thank you for your kind patience and active listening.
Thanks, Rahul. I wish Mr. Somajit and the organizer, if he can start with the question answer, or anybody wanted to discuss any particular points, we are very much available.
Okay. Okay, yeah. Mr. Uthpal. Fine. We have got some questions. We have one person called Mr. Anirban who has raised his hand. So, Mr. Anirban, you got a question, you can please ask. You are unmuted now. You can unmute yourself.
Rahul, sir, good morning.
Yeah, good morning.
Sir, the query that I had was, in one particular slide, you were explaining that for the throw of air through fabric ducting, there is a particular way that you can ensure that the throw happens in a particular direction, because sir, the fabric is what it is, perforated all uniformly throughout.
Yeah.
So as we saw in that video also, wherein the smoke was being put inside the duct, and it was it was distributing uniformly along its circumference. So
yeah,
is there a particular way in which you ensure that the throw goes in a certain as desired?
Yes. See, there are different types of air throw methods in the fabric ducting. Like there are total 5 types, to be precise. One is permeability. Second is the micro perforation, which you saw in the video. Third is the perforation, which is small holes up to 13 mm of diameter, from 4 mm to 13 mm of diameter. And then comes the small nozzles, which is from 20 mm to 40 mm nozzles. Then come the big nozzles, which is up to 80 mm. And then comes the spigot, which is bigger than nozzle, just a big big hole, like with the proper reducers. So yes, the any type of airflow can be achieved with the fabric ducting. So as well as you are concerned in terms of direction, direction can be provided in the any direction in the 360 degrees. From 90 degree, which is at 3 o'clock, to 180 degree, which is at 6 o'clock, to 270 degree, which is at 9 o'clock, as well as 0 degree, which is at 12 o'clock. When you go in terms of clock, so it can be provided as well.
Okay, sir, I just understood, like, based on the type of difference in the permeabilities and the perforations, we can give this direction to the airflow in fabric.
Yeah. Yes. Okay. Yes. Got so it. Each type of the air throw like each type of air through type, like micro perforation, it can throw up to 3 meters. Perforation, it can throw up to 8 meters. Small nozzles, it can throw up to 20 meters. Big nozzles can throw up to 30 meters. Like that, it goes on.
Yeah.
Like according to application, we might select the mode of transmission or mode of throwing of air.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Yes. Yes. Nice question, guys.
Now I'll ask some of the questions which I put up in the chat box as well in the QA. So I'll start with the chat box questions. Just a second. Yeah. The first question is from Swapnil Sombhav. The question is the scope of this duct designing in BIM. What is the scope of duct designing in BIM?
I just wanted to give the address for, you can say the answer for this. Like BIM is this module, right? It is a, you can say the new, most of the contractor, architect and consultant, they are using the BIM. And the software output, it is very much connected with the riveting. And it is the one of the important aspects, like the way we are selecting the ducting into the BIM, similar way you can be able to get the similar software outputs into the BIM. So it is very much comfortable and you can see the inline with the BIM modeling. The beauty of is, apart from the BIM is like the fabric ducting, you can doing the CFD analysis at the design stage. That is very important. However, it is very difficult to do a CFD analysis of a conventional ducting at the initial stage. Whereas in fabric ducting, you can do the complete balancing at the design stage itself. And the output of our software is in 3D only. Whatever the we are giving the outputs in a fabric ducting. In fact, we, as a industry professional, we must ask these details from the any of the manufacturer. Not only we, there are so many other manufacturers also are in India. So we must get each and every technical details, data sheets, drawings, from the manufacturer to find out exactly what is the balancing of the ducting is possible or not.
Okay.
Yeah.
So next question is from my side actually. You have shared about circular and oval duct installation as well as rectangular or square duct installation.
Mm-hmm.
Do you find it would be more difficult to apply insulation in a circular or an oval duct compared to a square or rectangular duct?
Insulation?
Yeah.
In fabric ducting?
No, in normal GI sheet ducting.
Normally, oval duct is mainly manufactured, oval and the round ducts are mainly manufactured as a factory fabricated. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So these ducts are already having a very much smooth processes in a factory to have a proper insulation. The pre-insulated ducting, we can say for that. And sometime on the site, of course, it depends on how the skill of the insulation labor, how is beautifully he can able to with the proper, with the dimension, he can make the insulation. So I don't think so, is there any problem for the insulation in the rectangular or the oval, as long as it is managed by the skilled workers.
Okay, one more question is, how can the fabric duct be cleaned from outside for aesthetic sense? Because
yeah, it is a washable. In fact, there are the certain procedures by the every manufacturers. They can have the washing into the 40 degrees Celsius of water with the proper detergent. It's a washing machine, industrial washing machine. So in fact, the beauty of the fabric ducting is it can be washable, whereas the conventional ducting cannot be washable.
That means the duct has to be removed and washed and then
Duct has to be removed sliding down from the hanging supports. It has to wash properly and it has to clean it, drain it in proper way and ironing it with the proper procedures given by the guidelines so that we can remove the wrinkles and you can again hang it straight away.
Okay. One more question from Mr. Shubham Maji is that what happens if the aspect ratio is more than 4?
In the conventional ducting, right?
Yeah.
So end of the day, it is depends on the completely as what CFM and what velocity we are planning to working on that thing, because every rectangular duct and the square duct, they has to work in a proper aspect ratio only in order to avoid the vibration and the noise, because the method what in the conventional way are selecting, it is different. It is not a static regain method. So that there is a loss of, with the aspect ratio, there might be possibility of the loss of the CFL. So if it is a more than 4 or it is somewhere not in that particular aspects, so we have to make sure that it should not be, it should be a properly, in fact, as per the application. It depends on how much height you are getting to design that aspect ratio.
Okay. Also, I would like to continue on this point is, as you increase the aspect ratio more than 4, in case of the rectangular ducting, the size of the width increases. Okay. So overall, the surface contact area increases for the air. So what happens in this case is, as this all parts contributes in the increase of frictional resistance. So frictional resistance, which further puts this increased static pressure load on the unit, the AH unit. So due to that, the AH unit motor size has to be increased, and thus it goes on to finally goes on to the point that it would cause more operating cost due to a faulty duct design.
Okay. Next question was from Sata Wari. Says that what are that segment and sector type ducts? I'm not very clear about the question what is asked.
Yeah, I can. Maybe he wanted to know the segment and sector. That is the our terminology of the things. So Rahul, can you open that screen? Or else I will just.
It is open.
They just open on the segment and sector.
Okay.
So basically, segment is like a. I will just show you. No, the segment. It's like a semi half round. Is less than the half round, and this you can open. So this is
okay. This
is the segment, and this is the sector. Sector is not mentioned over here. Sector is just like an incline for the villa and the bungalow. So semi segments where the height from the fall ceiling is less. So this is a half round, and this is a segment. You can see the easily difference between the half round and the segment.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Next question is from Sanivan Chakravarti. I think that is well answered. That is the perforation and the particular throw.
Yeah.
Next question again from Mr. Subhan Maji. How do we change or reduce the noise by varying other aspects?
From which ducting? Is it a conventional or a fabric?
I would believe that it is talking about conventional ducting.
Yeah. So in conventional ducting, the first of the important thing is the acoustic. And usse bhi sabse important cheez hai aapka vibration from the machines. So first we have to see the how best possible we have installed the machine with the proper mountings, because the vibration is generated from the noise is generated from the vibration and the loose connections, or the, you can say, the improper installation. So we have to see the first installation and then the connection between the ducting, because ducting is a medium which can take the noise also along with the air. So we have to see the how the mounting has been properly installed, and then third is the insulation, the acoustic insulation. So there are lots of good quality of the insulations are available in the market to avoid the noise. You can say we have to see the sound pressure and the sound power details exactly, and the dampers, how properly we have installed the dampers.
Okay. So presently we don't have any more questions. So if anybody of the attendees can raise their hands if you want to ask any questions, I can unmute you all. Oh, there's one more question. By the time I talk, what happens if duct work? What happens if the duct work is undersized?
Yes, very nice problem. And very practical question.
Yeah, good one, really, Shubham.
Yeah, very good. I'm really appreciate. You touch the one of the important nerves of the system. I think those who are in the HVAC industry, they can easily correlate. Yeah, because it is very important to design air distribution systems. It doesn't matter how your best brand of the HU or the chillers, end of the day, air distribution systems play a very important role. If it is under design, then it's completely imbalancing the overall system. It is not only impacting the required result, it's also impacting affecting on the backside of the equipment performance altogether. So your equipment may not able to function as what we are expecting. So that will impact the efficiency of the equipment, like the air handling units. Secondly, we are not getting the airflow and the comfort level from the area where it is designed. So it is very important to design a system very properly.
Definitely. And that is the challenge which we face in any side, because the space is a major concern everywhere.
Yes, absolutely, sir.
So, okay, so there are no more questions at present. Achha, one more question. What is the best material for duct work? I think,
I think, actually, this is a very, you can say, the one of the important factors, like, what are the available solution in front of us? I can give the answer is in that way. Because so far in the industry, we are very used to with the conventional way of a ducting. So that is the GI, aluminium or SS. But it doesn't mean that they are the only best things are available or they are the only worst things can be available. No, it depends on what are the application and what is the important things is available in front of us. Say example, if it is an application of a food grade industry, then we must suggest it should be SS304, like SS ducting. Okay. But there is a fabric is also available for the food grade industry with the antibacterial treated fabric. For any outside application, the galvanized iron, the aluminum ducting is very important. And whatever the inside application, where there is no requirement of the false sealing, then the fabric is very, you can say, the useful. So it is depends on what is the application and what are the solutions available. So now the choices is completely with the designer, which material they can able to select based on the application.
Very true, because it also, as you rightly said, it depends on where the duct is being put.
Yeah, absolutely. It's very important. In fact, you know, which is the biggest competitor for the fabric ducting in the market? It's the mindset and awareness.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Very true. Okay. I hope the presentation can be shared.
Yeah. No issue.
Okay. There is one question in the Q&A. From Mr. Kedar Yul. How do you reduce the minor losses which happens when joining the ducts of different sizes?
Yes, this problem occurs when in terms of the conventional ducting, in the metal ducting. That's why the jointing and the mounting materials which are useful, using for the connection of the two pieces and the insulation, the paint, the cleat, okay, the insulation. It's very important. So it is completely depends on the skills of the engineers or the laborers who is making this thing. So it can be avoided with the proper handling and the process only. And in the fabric ducting, actually, this question is not arising because everything is taken care of with the help of the fabric connection.
Right. Very true. Okay. There's one more question from Mr. Shuma. How do you make duct transitions?
Okay. You mean to say transition piece?
Yeah, I believe, because the question is incomplete, but still let us answer that part.
Yeah. Okay. You want me to answer?
Yeah, please.
So transition piece exactly what? When, say example, ductable, the supply portion is this rectangular, right? Now this Raul has shared the screen and the duct is a rectangular or round. So now, if you see, it is, sorry to say, but in our industry, this all transition piece has been made based on what is the available space. That's correct. There is no calculation for that. But whereas in a fabric ducting, it is completely based on how to avoid the static loss, how to avoid the vibration in that particular zone. And it can be made with the rectangular to the round, rectangular to the half round. Okay. So various shapes. So all these curvatures, these pieces can be made based on the proper selection so that we can avoid the major vibration and the noise at the initial stage.
Right. Okay. So we are getting loads of questions now. So there's one question which is related to the earlier answer which you gave. What are the types of duct joints?
Mm-hmm.
So there, I think this is very elementary. There is a lot of things are there, no? There's bolts, nuts, and plates.
Yes.
So I think Swapnil, you can talk to any of the HVAC installation engineer. you can get a full page of list of this.
Yeah,
depending on the location.
True.
Okay, what, there's a question from Mr. Shubham. What is the main advantage of fabric or textile duct? I think aesthetics is there. If you,
You can say that is the, according, although we are the manufacturer of the fabric duct, but I can say that is the least advantage. सबसे बड़ा एडवांटेज तो फैब्रिक डक्ट का ए है कि आप डिजाइन कर सकते हैं एज पर योर सिस्टम रिक्वायरमेंट एंड दैट इज अ फैक्ट्री फैब्रिकेटेड. तो सबसे और मोर इम्पोर्टेंट स्ट्रक्चरल लोड सेविंग. यू कैन सेव अ ह्यूज अमाउंट ऑफ द स्ट्रक्चरल लोड. सेकेंड, इट्स अ यूनिफॉर्म डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. द यूनिफॉर्म डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन इज नॉट इवन पॉसिबल फ्रॉम द जीआई डक्टिंग. द यूनिफॉर्म डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन इज पॉसिबल फ्रॉम द फैब्रिक डक्टिंग सो दैट यू कैन अवॉइड द ड्राफ्ट. ओके, द कंडेंसेशन फ्री, नो इंसुलेशन रिक्वायर्ड. No insulation required at all for a fabric ducting. Although it is you are traveling the duct from the non-air conditioning area to the air conditioning area, the insulation of the fabric is itself is a fabric. Okay, so we normally the fabric manufacturer having that system with them, and you can design the system as per your customized requirement. So that is the beauty.
Okay.
It's washable. It's, you can have the any kind of the art, colors. That is a later on.
Right. Okay. This question is in a duct only heat loss is possible, then how heat gain is inducted?
Heat gain?
Yeah. The heat gain is not a part of ducting at all.
Yeah, it's not a part of ducting.
So you can ignore the question. Standard duct size in HVAC, that also depends on location to location.
CFM and the static and the
maintenance of ducts, how are they carried out? I think these are questions which can be answered by any of the technical installers.
Yeah.
Fine, I think we have there's some more. In textile ducting, the fabric duct, is there any problem regarding the velocity?
To be very honest, a fabric ducting, we can design the velocity which is 14 meter per second also. That is huge. You can understand, right?
Mm-hmm.
And it depends on the what is the types of fabric we are having. So our this fabric is not a kapda. This is not a canvas.
Mm-hmm.
This is not a regular kapda or a canvas where if somebody is thinking like this is a normal kapda or canvas. No, actually it is not. It is a polyester. And every fabric manufacturer is having some fabric which is a patented. Like if you can take an example of us, we have 18 patented fabrics. Depends on the application.
Okay.
So it is completely from minus 50 degrees Celsius to 160 degrees Celsius. We have the fabric. Yeah. So it is like depending on the applications, the fabric is available.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Right. So no other questions suddenly now. So I think we have come to the end of the presentation, sir.
Nice. In fact, I appreciate the curiosity of the students.
There's one more. Sorry. People are realizing with the answers which you are giving. Can a gas line touch a furnace duct?
Can a
gas line touch a furnace duct?
Maybe I may not understand exactly. Can a gas line touch a furnace duct? No, actually, duct is designed. If I'm understanding it very clearly, he wanted to understand a gas line can touch a duct bottom, right? Or duct bottom can be touched.
Yeah. If there is a side challenges wherein two things are coming in contact.
Yeah, that's why the coordination between the drawings, like the plumbing drawing, the firefighting lines, the gas line is very important. So that's AutoCAD play very important role. So if any fabric ducting manufacturer is giving the duct based on the rupees per square meter, we should not select. We should ask the drawing first so that this kind of the challenges can be avoided.
Correct.
Yeah.
Okay. There's a question actually on duct designing. What is the best method of duct designing? That is, I think, already explained.
Static rigging method. Yeah.
Yeah. You have explained it properly. Fine. I think we'll have to close now. Whatever questions, all your email IDs can be shared. People can revert to you on a mail and they can ask you the right questions directly, whatever all their queries.
Perfect.
So you may just type in any of the chat box or Q&A.
Okay, Rahul, you can just text your email ID. And if somebody's having any more questions, we can address them.
Okay, sure.
Yeah, you can type it as to all panelists and attendees. Huh? So everybody gets it.
Okay, just hold on.
Nice, Mr. Sumajit, and it was a good interaction. In fact, you know, especially the east side of the India, the Calcutta, the majority, the players from the ducting industry are from that area.
Yeah,
you know better. Yeah, and like we are in Bombay, but since like we are understanding that the quality and the people are available in the East India for the ducting is really nice, and the majority, if you see the transforming of the ducting industry, is very important now. Because now it is not the only labor-oriented job. Now it's a skill. And we know the shortage of the labor after the COVID. It is very important that every design has to be having a proper background.
Definitely, definitely. So thank you for your support, Mr. Vilas, as well as your team, Rahul and
Pritam.
Yeah. Pritam. So it was really very enlightening, I believe. And something which is very basic but very important, I must say, as per my experience of air conditioning industry. So it's a pleasure having you all, and we'll definitely connect again for any other queries.
Sure.
So, and that's the end of it, I believe. And no more questions. We have any last parting comments you want to share, Mr. Vilas, on your team? Anybody?
We just wanted to say thanks to you for the keen listening, and it is always an important opportunity for the industry professional to interact with the students, because they are the young generation, and they definitely, those who are interested to make their career into the HVAC, how the ISHRAE and the industry is important and to coming to them by making them the proper, you can say, the experienced with the industry for the HVAC, it is very important. So I'm thankful to you and the ISHRAE for arranging such a programs for the students.
Yeah, thank you. And considering a Sunday morning, I must say it's wonderful having you all with your entire team and discussing on something which is very important. Thank you.
Thank you. You're most welcome.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Thank you.